Ladies and gentlemen, my humble pranams to all of you. My greetings to all of you. I am not a speaker as such, but I'll speak through my heart. Some of you might be wondering what this businessman from Botswana is doing here and what made me to come here. Just last year I was browsing through internet and I came across this conference that was expected to take place in this month, this year, and what attracted me most is the four keywords. That's what attracted me. First one is spirituality. Second thing is the wisdom. Third thing is leadership, and fourth thing is management. I have taken it in the reverse order. Spirituality, a lot of things have been said and spoken. Wisdom, everyone knows what it is. Leadership, lots of theories, lots of research has been done, everyone knows what it is. Management, everyone understands what it is. The issue that I see that is being discussed is how do we synthesize and bring them together into one person. A person, if he is a spiritual, is a manager, is a leader, how is it possible? Spirituality is more a relaxed type of situation, whereas leadership and management is more action-oriented. So how one person can cope with balancing these attributes? So I personally feel that one should learn how to practice them in unison and bring a balance that will bring harmony in life. I just want to share a few of my experience and thoughts. As a chairman of the Sachsai Central Trust of Botswana, I was actively involved in the operations of the Sai Center. And at one time, I came across an interesting quiz. What spiritual type are you? I tried to go through the test myself. And I've seen it's very interesting. There are 8 types of spiritual types classified. And it was so amusing also. After I went through it, I tried to test it with my colleagues in the Sai Center. And I came across some very startling results. There are 6 participants. It was a small group, so only 6 people came. The 3 men, 3 women. And when the test scores were calculated by me after they answered the quiz,